the big changes that has occurred since I initially began research in this field is the progression from studying diseases in hatchery situations to studying them in the wild. And they're very different. And in the hatchery, you have a captive population. You know when mortality is occurring. But we had to develop a whole new set of techniques for studying disease in the wild, because fish that die in the wild disappear from the population. They're either preyed upon by larger fish, or they die and they sink to the bottom. So over the years, we've been able to develop some really good predictive tools using molecular techniques. They're allowing us to answer questions that we never would have considered before. We're using them to look at the numbers of parasites or numbers of bacteria in a single liter of water, so that we can make predictions and measure things in the environment, which is really exciting. And we're also getting to the point where you can sequence an entire parasite genome. We're able to collect samples and make predictions about disease effects at a population level on the salmonid fisheries. And this is of importance to coastal communities that rely on these salmon fisheries for their livelihoods. This laboratory is also a wonderful tool. It was built in the 1990s as a state-of-the-art research facility for studying fish disease, and it really remains so to this day. Researchers come from across the country to do research here, and it's a great facility. I have always done art of some form or another. When I moved to the Pacific Northwest in the early 1980s, I became more aware of how iconic salmon were to this region. And that became an area where I was interested in working, both in my research, and it kind of filtered through into my art over the years. And I think that the scientific method has also informed my artwork, because it's a very experimental process. The series Pages from a Naturalist Notebook has been a more recent series for me, and I've enjoyed that it pulls together both the scientific aspect of experimenting with new methods in glasswork, as well as being able to pull in imagery, sometimes from actual field sites where we work. What has been fascinating about this research project is it's a big puzzle, and this is interesting to me. What is the life cycle of the parasite? And we were actually able to solve that, and we found out that this polychaete worm that lives in freshwater, it's very, very small, about the size of an eyelash, was an integral part of this life cycle, and it was actually the definitive host for this parasite. But once we solved the life cycle, it opened up a whole set of new puzzles. I have graduate students that are taking different parts of this complex life cycle and asking very specific questions, but they have to work as a team in order to see the big picture and to answer those questions. One of the things that's really excited me about our research as we've expanded over the last 5 years is that we're interacting more with the public. We're talking to watershed groups. We're working with commercial fishermen and farmers. We've talked with congressional people, watershed groups and councils, and both I and my graduate students have had the opportunity to make our research understood and of interest to this diverse community of stakeholders. And in turn, they've also provided us with a lot of really good input into how we might conduct our research.